Good day to everyone. I'm here with a lesson in social studies. The topic is of great importance today because it is on communication. Right now I'm communicating with you all through the mobile phone and internet. So communication is our topic for today. Please open your books on page 247. How do you send and receive messages? Circle all the means you use. So you get messages through the mobile phone, through the email, through letters, and also through video chat, and sometimes you get a message through telephones too. That is verbal messages. Typed messages are through mobile phone and email and letters. Next one. Do you think it is important to listen to the news? Why or why not? Yes, it's very important to listen to the news because that's how we come to know of what's happening right across the world, in front of us, behind us, in the next countries next to us, and also in the towns close to where we live. So it is important for us to listen to the news through radio, watch the news on television, and read the newspapers. Human beings are superior to all other animals because of their ability to communicate with each other. In early times, horses, pigeons, and signals were used to send and receive messages. These messages took a long time to reach. Modern long-distance communication began with Samuel Morse's invention of the electric telegraph in 1840. With the invention of the telegraph, sending and receiving messages became easier, quicker, and more reliable. Today, the telegraph has become obsolete. Human beings are superior to all other animals because of their ability to communicate with each other. In early times, horses, pigeons, and signals were used to send and receive messages. These messages took a long time to reach. Modern long-distance communication began with Samuel Morse's invention of the electric telegraph in 1840. With the invention of the telegraph, sending and receiving messages became easier, quicker, and more reliable. Today, the telegraph has become obsolete. So here, the first way in which we send messages was by the telegraph. You remember in the olden days, before I think maybe in the 1970s, 78, up to even the 80s, there was a system known as a telegram. A post telegram man used to come to the house, maybe even in the middle of the night, and say, "There's a telegram for you." So that is now no more. That is obsolete, means that telegram, the way of getting news or information through telegram, is no more in work. It's not functioning anymore. Instead, we get mobile calls, we get emails, and we get even telephone calls. So this telegraph was invented with by Samuel Morse in 1840, and he had a code known as the Morse code. So when we go to a post office in those days and we say, "I want to send a telegram to my friend saying, come, tomorrow is a party in my house, or come for a party after 2 weeks on such and such date," we go to the post office and we tell the man who's sitting at the counter, who's working at the telegraph table machine, to type out the message. And he has a printer sort of thing, and in that he uses the Morse code. It is a sign with each letter of the alphabet has some distinct sounds and taps and signs. With that he sends the message. The message is sent through wireless to the next nearest post office where you have to send the message to. And then that is again deciphered or translated into the language, and then the telegraph man takes it and delivers in the respective house or to the respective person. Now that is an age-old practice. Now that is no more there. Instead of telegram, we have the email and the voice message and the WhatsApp and mobile phone. All those have come into practice. Now the first one is telephone, the very old telephone that we had in our house was the landline. Now all of us now have the mobile phones. Now mobile phone and landline have a major difference. One is a landline uses the optic fiber or metal fiber for transmission of messages, whereas a mobile phone has the radio waves or the radio signal. That is why you see there are some companies like Vodafone and Airtel and BSNL, they have put up long towers or very big towers on top of buildings to catch the radio waves. And these radio waves are important in sending and receiving messages for the mobile phones. And landline phones are usually fixed to one particular place, but now even landline phones have become cordless type. You can carry the handset and walk around and make calls and get calls too. So coming to the telephone. In 1896, Alexander Graham Bell invented the telephone. It was the quickest and only instrument which allowed two people to speak to each other directly. Communication satellites now enable us to speak to people in different states and countries through the STD and ISD facilities respectively. Thus, messages can be conveyed to people living in other countries in a matter of seconds. Now, people can make and receive calls on mobile phones that they can carry around with them in cars, trains, and even on planes. Besides the telephone, there are other means of communication which address a wider audience. These means of communication are called mass communication.
Modern means of communication. Sachin and Meena have reached Andaman and Nicobar Islands. Sachin calls his father to inform that they have reached their destination. Modern means of communication has brought the world closer. Earlier, it would take days, months, or maybe years to send a message to people staying far away. In fact, communication of early man was in the form of actions or carvings on caves or trees in the pictorial form. As communication developed, people started using different types of languages to communicate. The invention of paper and press brought a drastic change in written communication. Initially, letter, telegram, speed post, etc. were the only means of communication. Later, the most remarkable invention of Alexander Graham Bell, that is, the telephone, started being used. Telephone, pager, mobile phones, etc. are considered as instant means of communication. The fax machine helps to send facsimile of documents and pictures instantly. Computer with internet and email facilities has developed the means of communication. Internet is not only the means of communication, but it also helps to gather information in various fields. There are two types of communication, personal communication and mass communication. Letters, telephones, mobile phones, etc. are means of personal communication, while press, television, radio, etc. are means of mass communication. These help to spread news and information on a large scale. Also, the impact of such communication is immediate. Newspaper is one such commonly used mass communication. Hundreds of newspapers are printed in variety of languages. These cover information about sports, politics, recruitment, property, etc. Mass communication helps to spread education and make people aware about the happenings in the world. It is also a means of entertainment. Artificial satellite made by man helps to gather information by orbiting the Earth. This information in turn helps to forecast weather conditions. The weather report on radio and television makes people alert, and hence timely precautions can be taken.
In 1896, Alexander Graham Bell invented the telephone. It was the quickest and only instrument which allowed two people to speak to each other directly. Communication satellites now enable us to speak to people in different states and countries through the STD and ISD facilities respectively. Thus, messages can be conveyed to people living in other countries in a matter of seconds. So you have the mobile phone, you have the ISD international system of dialing, and you have the local system of dialing. You just have to put the international country code, then dial the phone number of the person that you're trying to call, and immediately you get connected and you can deliver the message, whether it's a birthday or a wedding anniversary or a welcome message, whatever it is, or something else, within seconds. Now people can make and receive calls on mobile phones that they can carry around with them in cars, trains, and even on planes. So now even the landline technology has developed so far that the fixed telephone line or the landline has become cordless, and in addition to that, we have the mobile phones we can carry with us in our bags or in our hand, wherever we want, to whichever place. And wherever you go, there is a mobile connectivity, because radio, mobile towers are put up in many places all across the world. So you don't lose connectivity with your friends and family, no matter how far you go. But there are some places that have no connectivity too. That is where your phone goes and you have no range or no network. Besides the telephone, there are other means of communication which address a wider audience. These means of communication are called mass communication. Now, in a telephone, if you take and call a person, you talk to one person or maybe two persons in a video chat, or three or four. Now you have Google and you have Zoom, so you may be 10, 20, 30, and even 200 people at one time. But if you have to reach out to more than 100 people, there are other ways and means of communication. And that comes to newspapers, cinemas, and television, and also computers and internet. So the phone is a means of communication, but it is only to a limited number of people. So if you want to communicate with a larger number of people, then you have to use the newspapers or the cinema or the TV or computers and internet. Now let us come to the printed word. The printed word is the newspaper. The printed word, through books, magazines, journals, and newspapers, was among the first means of mass communication. Newspapers bring news to their readers. They give information about people and events. Newspapers also carry special articles, advertisements, weather reports, sports news, crossword puzzles, cartoons, and information regarding television and radio programs. The printed word, through books, magazines, journals, and newspapers, was among the first means of mass communication. Newspapers bring news to their readers. They give information about people and events. Newspapers also carry special articles, advertisements, weather reports, sports news, crossword puzzles, cartoons, and information regarding television and radio programs. Now, the newspaper comes to our doorstep every morning. Now, it is called news because it starts with N-E-W-S. That means news from the north, east, west, and south. Everything is clubbed together, born in one, and distributed as the newspaper. Now, we ought to read the newspaper because we come to know of what's happening in the different countries around the world just some days before, hours before, even minutes before. Where the different sports are being played, what kind of sports are being played, what vaccine is found out now for coronavirus. So all these updates are there in the newspaper. And in order to update ourselves with the scenario across the world, we have to and must read newspapers. Now, there is one thing I want to tell you, that the oldest newspaper in the English language was the Oxford Gazette, published in 1665. The oldest newspaper in the English language was the Oxford Gazette, published in 1665. And people believe that the oldest newspaper was in a German language that was published in 1605. The English language newspaper came into being in 1665, but the first newspaper, believed to be the first newspaper, was in the German language, and that was brought out by a person named Johann Carolus in Germany in 1605. Now, as I told you, newspapers are an important source of recreation also. Many people get, word puzzles over there and sit and solve the puzzles. It takes a lot of their time, and also it's very good for the brain. It keeps the brain working. Then people, those who are interested in sports, they get their schedule for the different sports tournaments. And seeing that timing, they can watch the live telecast on TV. For ladies, there's a column on beauty, health tips and cookery. For children, of course, every week, as you know, there's a page for children with a lot of general information and also some short story and a write-up about animals or birds or some scientific discovery. So in short, a newspaper has something for everybody in the house. Now coming to radio. Everyone knows that the radio was started or discovered by Marconi in 1895, and we had the famous All India Radio. Before Doordarshan, we had the All India Radio giving the news, and everybody was tied to the radio sets and the transistor to listen to songs and to the news. So coming to radio, on page 248, radios revolutionized mass communication. The first radio signals were transmitted by Marconi in 1895. Radio broadcasts can reach listeners in every part of the world, in towns, cities and villages. Radio broadcasts can be used to transmit information, news and entertainment even to those who cannot read or write. Radios revolutionized mass communication. The first radio signals were transmitted by Marconi in 1895. Radio broadcasts can reach listeners in every part of the world, in towns, cities and villages. Radio broadcasts can be used to transmit information, news and entertainment even to those who cannot read or write. Now you see the radios, the newspaper has everything in print. So only people who are literate can read the newspapers. But when it comes to a radio, a person who is unable to read and write also is able to listen to the news and understand what's going on. Now the radio has quizzes for small children. The radio has cookery time for the ladies of the house. The radio has time for musical programs. The radio also gives you devotional songs. Radio talks about live matches telecast. It goes on, the commentary. If there's a football match being played in Mohun Bagan or in Calcutta, the live commentary of the match is relayed to the radio and people enjoy that. So a radio is also a media of mass communication. Next one is cinema and television. Cinema has influenced the lives of millions of people. Social themes presented through cinema have a greater impact on people than books, newspaper or the radio. One is cinema and television. Cinema has influenced the lives of millions of people. Social themes presented through cinema have a greater impact on people than books, newspaper or the radio. Now the radio is one that we listen to, but thing is we are only listening to, we are not able to see anything. Newspapers are something that we read, but we are not able to see any visuals. But the cinema is something that gives you a visual too. You can see, you can listen. That has much more effect to the human brain than only reading or only listening. Because radio offers you only listening. Newspaper gives you only reading. But the cinema and television gives you both. It gives you listening to and it gives you viewing. And that has a greater impact on the human brain. So people enjoy watching television and enjoy watching the cinema too. And this is a media where many are influenced. The cinema and television has influenced a lot of people around the world. Cinema has influenced the lives of millions of people. Social themes presented through cinema have a greater impact on people than books, newspapers, or the radio. Television is perhaps the most popular means of mass communication. All of us have televisions at home, and many of us now during the COVID season, you can say many of them have online classes through the television, like the Victors. The Kerala State Board is offering all its classes through Victor's channel on television for all the Kerala State School syllabus students. So television has become a way or a media through which children are taking their online classes. Television is perhaps the most popular means of mass communication. It was developed during the period 1920 to 30. We depend on television for up-to-date coverage of events, news and views, information and entertainment. All these can be viewed in the comfort of our home without going out to the theatre. So if there is a football match being played in Brazil, that a live telecast is given here, sitting in the whole house, on your sofa, eating potato chips, you can watch the match. If there is a movie going on, you can sit at home, relax on the sofa and watch the movie. So all these things are available at your fingertips if you are able to work on the remote, change the channels according to the remote that you have in your hand, and you can enjoy a day at home just watching TV. A live telecast of an event such as a game can be viewed by people even as it is happening, making it more interesting. So sitting here, you can watch a cricket match that is being played in West Indies, or a match that is being played in Dubai, or a football match that is playing in Argentina. Sitting in the comfort of your home, you can just, you know, play with your fingers on the remote and you get everything on the screen. With this, I come to the end of the first part of the lesson. Your work as homework will be to read the lesson properly, understand each and every line, and if possible, to stick cuttings of two newspapers. The heading, I want the heading. Just cut the heading of two newspapers and stick in your notebook. Thank you.